Let's talk about why some EVs come with two charge ports, one for NACS and one for J1772. NACS, which is Tesla's connector, is actually designed to handle both AC and DC through the same port. When you plug in at home, it's running AC power at around 240 volts. But when you plug into a supercharger, it switches to DC and that can go all the way up to 1000 volts. Same port, same pins. It just changes the type of current flowing through it. Some newer EVs still have two ports, a NACS port for DC fast charging and a J1772 port for AC, like you see in the new Nissan Leaf. That's mostly for compatibility, since most public AC chargers in the US still use J1772, while DC fast chargers are moving towards NACS. Here's where it gets interesting, and it's really about voltage and safety. At home, your level 2 charger runs on 240 volts from the standard split phase system we all have. But in commercial buildings, you often see 277 volts instead, which comes from a 480 volt 3-phase system. It's called the 277 volt paradox, because it's just 37 volts higher than home voltage, but it's different enough to matter. That small jump from 240 to 277 changes how connectors are built. The insulation and spacing inside a plug that's certified for 240 volts might not be safe at 277. If you plug a 240 volt rated charger into a 277 volt supply, things can overheat or fail safety checks. Teslas are designed to shut off in case of a voltage mismatch. That's why keeping AC and DC ports separate makes sense in one way. The J1772 handles 240 volt AC safely, and the NACS port takes on high voltage DC, all the way to 1000 volts, without worrying about those AC certification limits. Eventually, NACS will probably take over both, one port for everything, because it already can do both AC and DC. We are just waiting for all the public infrastructure to catch up.